good all the time. Can we just give him one shout of praise in this house?
I can hardly go this year. I see you.
do this song. Well, there ain't no grave. We'll be right back. statement, you can't go off a feeling. You ever heard that? Go away. You can't go off a feeling, but I'm glad he gave me something I can feel. Some people say that God's just in our mind. Pray over them and anoint them with oil. any sin will be forgiven, any sickness will be healed. And I'm just a believer this morning that God can heal him right now, on the spot. I'm going to help you believe that. If you believe that, give the Lord a hand. All you men and women, come on up here. If you believe in, listen, if you don't believe in healing, don't come. If you believe in healing, come on. We're going to just speak life over here.
Oh, he'll deliver me in my time of need. Like those Hebrew children from the fire. Thank you.
Everybody hear me? How many is tired of church as a norm? How many is hungry for a move of God? Really hungry. I said, how many is hungry for a move of God? Hallelujah. How many has been discouraged enough? How many has been through the battle enough? How many wants to say, devil, enough is enough? We're ready for a move of God. How many knows he's stolen from us long enough? How many knows we've been sick in body long enough? We've been discouraged long enough? I'm telling you, we're serving a God this morning that's got the power to move on us and move for us and move through us. And if anybody here this morning would agree with me that God has the power to change our situation. Hallelujah. Oh, hear what the word of the Lord says. When the day of Pentecost had was fully come, they were with all with one accord in one place. Suddenly there came a sound from heaven as of a rushing high wind. It filled the house where they were sitting. There appeared unto them cloven tongues like as of fire. It set upon each of them, and they were all filled with the Holy Ghost and began to speak with other tongues as the Spirit of God gave them the utterance. And I tell you this morning that that is the first initial outpouring of the Holy Ghost in this New Testament church. And may I say to every naysayer, we are still in that New Testament church. And what Jesus began to do in that early church, he wants to accomplish in this church today. And can I tell you, there is a move of God. He's willing to move upon us. He's willing to pour out his Holy Ghost power on us. All we got to do is be an open willing vessel for the power of the Holy Ghost to rest upon. You ought to grab your neighbor right now and say, get ready. God's going to do something in the midst of his people. You know, I know this morning we got every type of denomination here. I know we got every upbringing here. But I'm not worried about what background you come from. I'm not concerned about what doctrine you're thinking about or believing in. I'm telling you that this Bible is true. And I'm telling you, in order for God to move, we got to quit worrying about where we came from, what denomination we're out of, and we got to get hungry for a move of God. I heard the Bible say, he that hungers and he that thirsts after righteousness shall be filled. Come on, somebody. Oh! Well, I wasn't expecting this, Pastor, when I came to your church. Listen, I'm tired of just sitting through normal services. I want God to move. And when I leave here, I'm going to be changed. And if I'm not changed, there ain't no sense in me coming to church. Help me right now. If I ain't changed from faith to faith and glory to glory, there ain't no sense in me coming here. Help me right now. When the Holy Ghost fell in that upper room, all their discouragement left. When that Holy Ghost fell in that upper room, all they've been through walked out the door. Everything they had in their mind left. Can I tell you this? You will not make it. No, sir. You will not make it. That world will drag you right back out unless you got a power living in you that's greater than the flesh you're living in right now. Can I tell you that's what God wants you to do? He wants to give you the power of the Holy Ghost to become a witness of Him. Not only in word, but in deed. How many of you say right now, preacher, I want that? That I want you to come and stand across the front of this building. Hallelujah. I know this ain't a normal big preacher, but that's alright. If you need God to move for you right now, I want you to come and stand across the front of this building. Preacher, you're going to run people off. People won't ever come back. It's alright, come on. You get God to build, the multitudes will come. I said, you get God in the building, multitudes will come. Well, hallelujah. Do you think I'm going to go through this crowd and pray for everybody? But how many know that sometimes you need to pray for yourself? Come on. Moses said, the Lord has to tell me to shout before I shout. I'm glad you said that, because he filled the book telling you to shout. Shout and give praises unto God. Anybody this morning feel like you've been to church? Whoa. I feel like the Lord, it's been prophetically spoken over this church several weeks now. I believe the Lord has taken us to new dimensions. He's trying to show himself to us. And all we got to do is get in the place where we're hungry for him. Hallelujah. You know, anybody ever like those times when somebody you've not seen in a long time surprises you and shows up? Somebody you want to see, yeah, surprises you and shows up. That's how God feels probably when he walks in the building, because we don't have services. Our services sometimes are about us, and they're not about him. Sometimes he just wants times when we're surprised that he's showing up. But we welcome him into this house. I'm telling you, God can change us from glory to glory, from faith to faith. What a God, what a God. Hallelujah. We even took an offering in heaven. Brother Terry wants to read a piece of scripture. Come on, read that. You don't want to do it now, all right. I'm sorry, he texted me this morning and said, before you pray for Gerald, I want to read a piece of scripture. It totally slipped my mind, so I apologize for that. Maybe it's just to give to Gerald. So anyway, God's a good God. We're coming back tonight at 6 o'clock. We'll be here for service, and I hope you'll come with us. And maybe I'll preach something to get you all fired up a little bit. I don't know. But God's good. Turn around, shake five people's hands, and thank them for coming this morning. While I give some announcements right quick. You men come and... You men come and to take them for Sunday morning tithe and offering right quick. Everybody listen to me. We're going to take up Sunday morning tithe and offering while I give this some announcements, okay? Go ahead, man. Needs to meet with all the parents. If your child attends children's church here upstairs, if they attend it, she needs to meet with the parents in the fellowship hall for just a few moments right after church. How many of y'all know that this week is our men's conference? We are going away to a cabin in Lafollette to get away with the Lord to pray and seek his face and spend some time in the Word. We're going up on Thursday. I'll let you know more tonight. I'm going to pull the email up. Address and all that stuff and where we're going. I'll let you know more tonight when we're headed out and when we're leaving. We're going up Thursday evening. I think we can't be in the cabin until 3 or 4 o'clock. Brother Randy will go and get all the food that we're going to need up there. If you'd like to go, today's the last day to sign up. So back at the back, there is a sign-up sheet. We've got about, 13, 14 men, I guess, going from here, and then some from Pastor Chris's church up in Kentucky. They're coming down, and I'm going to be speaking at this men's retreat, and so is Pastor Chris. And then we're going to do something special. This year, we're going to, for all the men that go, all the preachers that go, when you get there, we're going to have one service where we have tag team preaching. There'll be three or four preachers that are younger preachers and hasn't been preaching as long as I have. What we're going to do is we're going to throw numbers in a hat. We're going to draw numbers out. Whoever ends up with number one is going to get the topic they're going to speak on, and they're not going to tell the rest of them. He's got 10 minutes to preach, and number two's got to pick up where he leaves off. We're going to come right on down to Adam and his name. So we're going to do that in one of the services up there, and it'll be fun to do and to hear from several different men. So we're going to do that at this men's retreat. So if you want to go, it's $100 to go. Like I've said in every service, if you don't have the money, if you'll come and see me, I'll make sure that you get to go. All right? And so come and see me. You have to have the money paid by Wednesday night. Okay? Today or Wednesday night. So make sure you have that to me before then if you are paying to go. Okay? You love the Lord? We'll come back tonight at 6 o'clock. If you are a visitor here this morning, we love you. We thank you for coming. We welcome you to the Redemption Harvest. Hope you come back to be with us in another service. How many wants to thank the Lord for what he did in this service and what he's going to do? Amen. We'll pray and come back and pray, and we'll see everybody tonight at 6 o'clock.
Church, show yourself friendly to our visitors. Oh!